If you're looking for the perfect Secret Santa gift or stocking stuffer this holiday season, head over to Amazon or Barnes & Noble and pick up a copy of the 7-Minute Leadership Handbook. Happy holidays and enjoy today's episode.
What is your leadership legacy? Today on the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast.
Helping leaders motivate their people to a higher level of performance through strong human relations, team building, and goal achieving. This is the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast with your host, Paul Falavolito.
And hello, everyone, and welcome to the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast. This is episode 73, and today I want to ask you a question. What is your leadership legacy? Leadership is about knowing who you are and having the confidence to express it. I think we can all agree on that one. Leadership is also about how you impact others in every area of their life, not just in the workplace. The way you influence people, the way they think, act, and the way they approach their job and their personal lives are all a direct result of you and having spent time with you and having worked with you. We all had those influential friends growing up, and we emulated them to some degree, the way they dressed or talked, and even their confidence. The same happens to you as a leader. If you're doing it right, people are going to notice and change things about themselves for the positive. This is your leadership legacy. A Harvard Business Review survey back in 2008 said that 58% of people would trust a total stranger more than they would trust their own boss. 58%. And think about that for a minute. Can you ever remember a time in your life when a parent would ask a total stranger to drive their children somewhere? Well, we live in that world now with Uber and Lyft. We have a cultural trust problem in our country, and it's no wonder why leadership suffers with that statistic. There is a major leadership issue, and there is definitely no leadership legacy that those bosses in that survey are leaving behind. You have to come to the point when you are evaluating yourself as a leader and ask yourself the hard question. If something happened to me today, what would my staff do? Now, I don't mean sit around and cry, and hopefully no one would say they would have a big celebration. I'm talking about in the workplace, what would change? Would they say now that he or she is gone, we are changing everything? Would they change your policies, the dress code? Or would they say that we aren't going to do it that way anymore? Or would your leadership legacy live on? And to understand your leadership legacy, you have to understand what that truly means. Your leadership legacy has nothing to do with the fact that you were the best dressed in the office. It has nothing to do with how many plaques are hanging on the wall with your name on it. It has nothing to do with being the top salesperson. It has nothing to do with your title. It has everything to do with who you are as a person and how you were able to impact and light the fire within people. That's your leadership legacy. And this ties in with the next statistic. A recent study on Career Builder's website says that also 58% of managers said they received no formal management or leadership training. They simply got promoted because they were good at their job, not because they were good at making the people around them better, just good at their job. This tells us that more than half the leaders in the workforce aren't trained to lead. Again, no wonder why many leadership legacies don't live on. I'm going to take a short break from my sponsor. I'll be right back to finish the discussion. This is the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast. I have suffered from chronic back pain for years. As a paramedic, my back is the number one body system that cannot fail me. And over the years, I've tried every over-the-counter pain medication, patch, and cream to help get me through those long shifts. None of them really worked well enough, but the first time I used the recovery balm from MuscleMX, my back pain was gone and stayed gone for the entire shift. CBD is such a hot product right now, and nothing is better than the products by MuscleMX. I swear by them. They make everything from balms, drops, to lotions, and they are all 100% natural, non-greasy, THC-free, and made in the USA with a 30-day money-back guarantee. I've partnered with MuscleMX to make available a special discount to my podcast listeners. Visit them online at MuscleMX.com and enter discount code PAULF for 10% off your order plus free shipping in the United States. Trust me, if you have pain anywhere in your body, MuscleMX will do the trick. And now, back to today's show. Leadership legacy. What do you leave behind when you're gone? Did you do enough to keep your beliefs and actions in the minds and the actions of others, or did you just do enough to be good at your job? You have to figure that out. When you hear the words, it's time for a fresh start, that's code for there was no leadership legacy to continue. I don't know about you, but those words terrify me. Those that truly believe in leadership and work at it know what I'm talking about. We liken it to planting a garden full of seeds that we hope continue to bloom long after we're gone. This has been the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast, and I thank you for listening.
For more Paul Falavolito podcasts, visit paulfalavolito.com.